Hello, I'm David Lee from BASSBOSS, and we've been asked what's the best practices for load distribution when hooking up a sound system. In general, you're going to have things that draw a lot and things that draw less and things that draw virtually nothing. From a point of view of what those things are, subwoofer amplifiers, to be specific, tend to draw the most power. The next most power, and although it's a significantly less power draw, is the mids and high cabinets. And then things that draw virtually nothing are your mixers, your control devices, CD players, that kind of thing. So the key to distributing your load is to put some of each of those things on each circuit so that you don't have all the subs on one circuit and then all the mids on another circuit. And you don't want two subwoofers and your mixer on a circuit and then mids on another circuit, because if the subwoofers overdraw that circuit, then the mixer goes down. So in general, what you want to make sure that you do is you distribute the load so that it is ideally, depending on how big of a draw, up to about 2,500 watts, is about half. I mean, realistically, that's all you can get continuous draw on a 20 amp circuit. However, amplifiers are dynamic draw devices, so they're not going to be like a light bulb or a fan where once the power's on, it's pulling that current constantly. It pulls that current at the beat peaks, at the voltage spikes, specifically at the impedance minimums, but it pulls that current and then it drops back down again, and then it pulls it again. So the average current that it draws is significantly lower than the peak. And of course, a bass hit is timed, usually in most music, is timed opposite of a snare hit. So if you have like the old boots and pants, so the subwoofer is going to be drawing from that circuit at a different moment from when the top is drawing from that circuit. The mixers and processors and CD players and whatever, computer laptops and stuff like that, those draw a constant draw. They're not fluctuating, but it's so little that they're not gonna affect what you're gonna have available for tripping the breaker. And you're just not likely to have enough of them to make any kind of impact. For BASSBOSS products, we use very efficient amplifiers, and different manufacturers have significantly less efficient amplifiers depending on who they are, what they do. Amplifiers that we use are 92 to 98% efficient, and that varies actually with level and frequency, but specifically high efficiency. Some amplifiers, particularly like toroidal transformer amplifiers or just transformer amplifiers in general that aren't switch mode and aren't as efficient, they tend to waste more power. So they'll draw about 30% waste current. So they're 70% efficient. So if you're using those, you have to factor that in, because that is a constant draw. That's not a fluctuating draw. The waste current is constant. With the switch mode amplifiers, the fluctuations run with the music draw. So when they're at a low state, very little current being drawn by them. Okay, so 2,500 watts, generally speaking, because of the dynamic nature of music, you can put roughly two of those on a 20 amp circuit, up to 4,000, maybe 5,000, depending on the nature of the content and what kind of load that amplifier is connected to, will be able to be run one on a 20 amp circuit. When you add a mid-high cabinet, again, the point is that you put it on the same circuit so that when the bass isn't hitting, the tops draw their bit and it's offset in time, so it's not pulling at the same moment. And it also is a significantly lower amount of power that it's demanding. So it's not really going to stress the breaker if you don't have them hitting at the same time, and they're not going to draw the same amount. So if you have an extra circuit, say for instance you have three circuits, you have one for your left side, one for your right side, and one for the middle, give your subs as much as you can, and then put your mids and highs and your mixing boards and front end gear on the third circuit as well. That way you have excess. You won't, even if a sub trips a breaker, you won't lose sound. You'll lose a sub maybe, or even two if they both pull breakers, but at least your sound will continue. Because the worst thing that happens is when it goes click, and everybody turns around and looks at the sound guy or the DJ. It's like, what happened? So we don't want that. So that's how and why we want to distribute the load to as many breakers as possible. So hopefully that helps you keep out of trouble with circuit breakers and keeps the music playing. Thanks a lot.